हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, जय हिंद, गुड मॉर्निंग, वेलकम बैक। इन आवर लास्ट लेक्चर, लेक्चर नंबर 12, आई हैव ऑलरेडी एक्सप्लेन यू एग्जांपल्स वेयर मोर देन सीएफ डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन इज गिवन, हाउ टू प्रिपेयर regular frequency distribution and how to find median, that we have studied last in our last lecture. Now what we are planning today, see dear student, if you have material with you, just you first verify, just take out your material by the time I write lecture number here and chapter number, okay? By the time I write here, you just take out your material and in that material you just try to verify one SLP, okay? Statistics, chapter number 14, and in today's lecture what is we are going to plan in today's lecture, try to understand. In today's lecture we are trying to first understand from the given frequency distribution how can you find mean, median and mode together. Not only that, but we will also, I will also explain some of the MCQ, one-liner, etc. from objective section which you need to practice, understand? So what we are planning first in today's lecture, one example where you have to find mean, median and mode together. You understood? So this is example number one today. Example number one. Actually, dear student, you know very well how to find mean individually, you know. How to find median individually, you know. How to find mode individually, that you know. If somebody asks you to find, give you an example to find mean, median or mode separately, you know how to do it because you have already understood that process of finding mean, median and mode together, that you know very well. Now what we are targeting is this. We are targeting such example where you directly have to find mean, median and mode all together. Understand, we are taking an example. This is example, find mean, note down with me, find mean, median and mode. We have to find all together from the given data, mean, median and mode. Note down class are given this way, 5 to 10. You know, dear student, how to find it individually. I am just explaining when together they are asked. In one example, you have to find mean, median and mode. That is what I am explaining, 5 to 10. Then you continue with the class, 10 to 15, okay, class length of 5, you can observe from here. then you just note down 15 to 20, 20 to 25, 25 to 30, just note down the observation class, 25 to 30, then the last class, 30 to 35, class are given, frequencies are also given, F that is given to you, just note down the frequency 11, then it is given 10, then it is given 35, 11, 20, dear student here, 11, 20, 35, then you note down 20, 8 and 6, okay? 8 and 6. Class are given, frequency are given, understand? Class and frequency are given. We are looking for finding mean, median and mode all together. That is what we are targeting, okay? So now, dear student, you treat this example as separately. Take an example. Your first target in this particular example, your first target is to find mean. So let us concentrate what is required for finding mean of the data. You all know very well, first you require to find class mark, that is xi. You know very well how to find the class mark, regular class height of 5, concentrate, 10 plus 5, 15, divide by 2, 7.5. Regular class height of 5, go on adding, 7.5 plus 5, it is 12.5. Plus 8, 5, it is 17. Add 5, it is 0.5. Just go on adding 22.5. This is 27.5 and 32.5. Now, as you know, to find mean, you require to make a column of di, that is xi minus a. You know very well the highest frequency. We are just reviving the process, dear student. You have already studied. This is just a question of making all columns in line and finding mean, median and mode at a time, okay? Class mark, then di. How you we mark di? The mid value against the highest frequency. Class mark against the highest frequency will become our, okay? And now, as you all know, a simple subtraction, this is minus 10, this is minus 5, you all know, this is 0, xi minus a, this is 5, this is 10, and this is 15, just xi minus a, this is just a revival of the process you have already done. Now let us go for ui, that's di upon h. you know how to make 0 as it is, then minus 1, minus 2, just carry on with me, 1, 2 and 3, then the column of Fi, Ui together, column of class mark has been made, column of Di equal to Xi minus A is made, column of Ui has been made, now column of Fi, Ui, you will multiply value of second column and last column, 11, 2 ja, this is minus 22, just carry on, 20 into minus 1, that is minus 20, 30 into 0, that is 0, 20 into 1, that is 20, 8 into 2, that is 16, 6 into 3, that is 18, and now finding, you know this process very well, you have done, okay, sigma Fi Ui, that's equal to, see dear student, I have already explained you, this minus 20 and plus 20 are cancelled. This is minus 22 plus 18 plus 16. This is 34 already. 34 minus 22. This is going to be 13. Okay. This is going to be 12, okay. We got sigma Fi Ui, then you have to find total of the frequency, that is sigma Fi, that is n, just go on adding 5 plus 1, 6, 6 plus 6, 12 plus 8. 20, 0, 2, carry, 2 plus 1, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 100 is sigma Fi Ui. These are, dear student, column you require whenever you have to find mean, that you know, column of Xi, class mark, column of Di, column of Ui, column of Fi, Ui, you know this very well. This many column formation are required for finding mean of the data. Now, dear student, try to understand. If I ask you, then we will calculate all together mean, median and mode together, that we will calculate. Suppose you think, dear student, if you have to find only median of the data, so you know that you will be given class and frequency. Now, if you want to find median of the data, which another column you have to make, that is column of cumulative frequency. Just go on telling here. First, frequency 11. So your CF 11, 11 plus 20, can you guess 31? 31 plus 35, you get 66, is it clear? Okay, no? Then 66 plus 20, understand that is going to be 86, 86 plus 8. It is going to be 94, 94 plus 6 going to be 100, so CF is also found out. These are columns, dear student, you have to make. Class, frequency, class mark, Di, Ui, FIUI and CF, just concentrate on one very important fact, that you will make all column for mean that you know. Then one extra column of CF you have to make. Here the three columns are already made. The only extra column you have to add, that is the column of cumulative frequency. Now let us continue one by one. First, let us move for finding mean x bar equal to a plus, you know the formula, FIUI upon sigma FI into N, okay? Into H, class height. Let us find what is the value of A. We have 17.5 plus sigma Fi Ui, that is 12, upon sigma Fi, that is N. You understood this? Class height is of 5 already, you know. You understood? Now the cancellation 520 ja. Further cancellation is possible, yes. 26 ja, 210 ja. So this is going to be 17.5 plus 6 upon 10. Still cancellation is possible, but we do not want to do, because decimal place is directly possible, 0.6. This is going to be 18.1. First you verify this properly. We have already found out mean of the data. Mean has been found out, x bar, understood? First you just understand, in column formation you know that you have to make all column and rest the column of CF, cumulative frequency. Now dear student, let us go for finding median of the data. What is the procedure in finding? This was for finding mean of the data. Now you have to involve yourself in the process of finding median of the data. How to find median? For that you have to recall the process again in your mind. Number of observation, I am writing it here now, n equal to 100. That means you know the formula. N equal to 100, that means m equal to n upon 2/OBS, you know it very well. 100 upon 2, that is 50th observation. 50th observation. Now dear student, be very very conscious. 50th observation, that means where you will find 50th observation in this column. Here you get 50th observation. This will be, try to understand, this will be your CF. In line of this, come here, this will be your F. You try to understand, and this will be your L. You understood this consciously? 50th observation means you will look in CF. Here you are not getting 50th, here you are getting, underline it, come in line of that, F, L, and previous CF will be the CF for us. And now dear, we have limit of board, so I am writing one or two steps, then I will continue inside. Please try to understand. Let us write the formula. L plus n upon 2 minus cf upon f into h. Further calculation I will continue here, at least for median. Okay, I am continuing here, dear student. Please concentrate. Equal to value of L, you know, 15 plus n upon 2, you know, 100 upon 2, that is 50, minus CF, never make any mistake, dear student, 31 upon F, that's 35 into class height, that is of 5. Now this is 15 plus 50 minus 31, that is 19. You understood this? Upon 35 into 5, just cross multiply, just cancel 5, 7, 15 plus 19 upon 7, convert it in decimal, 7, 2, 14, 5 left, 50, 7, 6, 42, 8 left, that is 80, 7, 7, 8, 9, 10, okay, don't worry at all, 2.61, that's sufficient, okay. Just a minute, here we are making one mistake, dear student. 7, 2, 14, 5, that is 50, yes. 7, just a minute, 2, then 7, 7, 49, 1 left, 7, 1, okay, 2.71, you add this, 17.71, you got mean and median both. Mean is found out, median is found out. Now it is a simple question of finding mode of the data. Here, dear student, you have one precise understand confirmation. Mean and median you know how to find now. Now, dear student, you have to remember one particular formula which shows relation between mean, median and mode. Please try to remember z equal to 3m minus 2x by, remember this formula. We will also understand the application of this formula in solving objective also. Z equal to 3m minus 2x bar, let me substitute the value, 17.7, okay, minus 2 into 18.1, just multiply, 3, 1, 3, 3, 7, 21, 3, 7, 21 plus 23, 2, 3, 1, 3 plus 2, 5, 53.13, and here 36.2, just the subtraction, 13 minus 2, understand this is 11, 13 minus 6, that is 7, 4 minus 3, 1, you got mode as 17.11. First you just verify this properly, okay. Whenever you are asked to find mean, median and mode all together, this is the way. You should not indulge in a process of finding mode separately. Once you have mean and median, you can directly apply in the formula z equal to 3m minus 2x bar. This is the formula which shows relation between mean, median and mode. Z equal to 3m minus 2x bar. If a little bit is not visualized, please understand, 3m minus 2x bar, you substitute value of n and x bar, just solve it by yourself, even some portion is not visualized, you can do it by yourself, z equal to 17.11. This is the way, dear student, you have to find mean, median and mode altogether. Whenever you are asked an example to find mean, median and mode, you should take enough care how to find them. Okay? So such example, before we go for solving some objective, this type of example are in your SLP 6, okay? So before we go for solving some MCQ, homework for this is you have to do SLP 6, okay, completely. There are three examples given in SLP 6 to find mean, median and mode together. So you have to calculate those examples to find mean, median and mode, okay? Now, dear student, we are not in today's lecture going to solve all objective because that's your part to do, okay? But at least in some of the MCQs, I would like to give some hints to you, okay? So I am giving hints in almost some of MCQs or one-liner which are given to you. Understand? So some MCQ revision we are doing, dear student, okay? So I am just taking some around 10 or 12 from objective section, okay? From objective section. In objective section, you all know there are four SLP, 8.1, 8.2, 8.3, 8.4, okay? Some are true, false, and somewhere fill in the blanks. Now what we are going to do just now, that I am taking few, understand, from SLP 8.1, okay? We are targeting just now SLP, means some of the MCQ I will like to take from SLP 8.1. Now try to understand, dear student, some of the MCQs to find model class, median class, that you can do very easily. How to decide median class and how to decide model class, that you know very well because you have already solved examples based on this. Now try to understand. If you are asked some of the MCQs, like, dear student, I have already discussed you even when I explain the subjective part, understand how to find mean, median and mode. At that time we had a discussion that suppose I write formula of mode, suppose I write it, this is formula of mode, you all know this formula very well, 2F1 minus F0 minus F2 multiplied by H. Actually, dear student, you know all designations here. If I ask you, some such MCQs are also given in objective section. In the formula of mode, what is H? What is H in the formula of mode? That is simply giving class height. In the formula of mode, what is L? You all know L means it is the lower boundary of model class, you know that. What is F1? You know that. F1 means, you can say, F1 means the frequency of model class. If I ask what is F0 in the formula of median, so you will immediately say F0 means the frequency of the class preceding the model class. F2, frequency of the class succeeding the model class. This way, designation can also appear in MCQ. Suppose I write formula of median, what is that? L plus n upon 2 minus CF. Please try to understand. Upon F into H. This is the formula of median already. Now if somebody asks you what is H, you know class height. That designations to appear in all formulas either of mean, median or mod everywhere. Now if my question is this, what is L? So you know it is lower boundary of median class. What is F? It is, try to understand what you have done in process of finding median of the data. F means it is frequency of median class. What is L? It is lower boundary of median class. What is CF? It is cumulative frequency of class preceding the median class. You understood this? So this is the way MCQ can be generated very easily from the formula of mean, median, mod, etc. In mean you know the formula A plus sigma fi ui upon sigma fi into H. Here also H means class height. What is A, dear student, in this? A is called assume mean. What is it called? Assume mean. What is ui? So you should know ui equal to di upon H. Somewhere to confuse you, it is also given that ui equal to xi minus a upon H, because ultimately xi minus a means di. So this way MCQ can be asked. Understand? Now try to understand one more thing, dear student. There are some MCQ based on this. So Z equal 3m minus 2x bar. This is a formula showing relation between mean, median and mod. If you verify in SLP 8.1, you just see the MCQ number 19. I am not going to solve it because the formula is already there. Z equal to 3m minus 2x bar. One only I will solve. Suppose 19. What is given, dear student? Read it first. 19. What is given in word? For some given data, we are solving MCQ number 19. Given data, if Z equal to 16, value of Z as well, value of M is given, that is 18, and you are asked to find X bar. You know, dear student, formula in front, Z equal to 3M minus 2X bar. This is the formula you have. Let us substitute the value. Z equal to 16 given, 3, M you know 18, X bar we are looking for. 16 equal to 18, 3 ja 54 minus 2x bar. Transfer 2x bar on this side, 16 on that side. So 2x bar equal to 54 minus 16. 2x bar equal to 48. Just you transfer x bar equal to 24 upon 2, that is 12. This is the way you can solve this MCQ. Here, dear student, concentrate here that this is the basic formula, Z equal to 3m minus 2x bar. Any two values given to you, you are definitely able to find the third value by yourself it's quite easy to find, okay? But suppose, dear student, if we take such MCQ, just take an example, if you take MCQ number 23, please take out. Just watch your material, MCQ number, just verify that. Formula is going to be the same. What is in MCQ number 23? What is given? For some given data, Z plus M equal to 108 and Z minus M equal to minus 6, then find the value of X bar. First I would like to write, that is MCQ number 23 we are targeting. What is given first, you note down that Z plus M is given, Z plus M. Please concentrate. This is given 108. Z minus M is given minus 6. These two equations are given to you. Z plus M 108, Z minus M minus 6. You know elimination method very well. This is cancelled. Z plus Z, that is 2Z. 108 minus 6, 102. Transfer 2 here, you got Z equal to 51. You know that. Put value in one of the equation. Z plus M equal to 108. 51 plus M equal to 108. You transfer. M equal to 108 minus 51. M equal to 8 minus 1, that is 7. 10 minus 5, 5. 57. You got Z and M by simply solving both the equation by method of elimination, and then you substitute the basic formula. Z equal to 3M minus 2X bar, Z that is 51, just concentrate. 3M, 3 into bracket 57. Minus 2x bar, let me continue here. This is, just watch, 51 equal to 37 21 to carry, 35 15 plus 2 171 minus 2x bar, just transfer. 2x bar on this side, this is on that side, 171 minus 51, 2x bar equal to 120. So we got x bar when you transfer here equal to 60. You watch the method, dear student, because in MCQ you have to be very, very conscious about, understand? Basic formula is going to remain the same, that is x bar equal z equal to 3m minus 2x bar. It is just a question of manipulating and applying the same formula when different one-liner and MCQ are there in front of you, okay? This is MCQ where two equations are given. We solved them by elimination, got one measure, substituted, got another measure, and then basic formula, Z equal to 3M minus 2X bar. Okay, dear student, is it clear? So some of the MCQ and one-liner are given based on this formula, okay? Some of the MCQ and one-liner are, dear student, quite simple, like find sum of 10 natural number, find sum of prime number, find median, that we have also taken median of ungrouped data, so those example you can solve by yourself. There is nothing new in that. Okay. Find mean of factor of 12. So factor of 12 you can take. Find mean of first 5 multiples of 5. First 5 multiple of 5 means 5, 10, 15, 20, 25. Then you go and find its mean. Okay. So those are some of the MCQ and one-liner you know very well. Now I would like to solve one more, dear student, for you. Suppose, just take one-liner 49 we are targeting. See, 49 from SLP 8.4 we are targeting. Just first you verify SLP 8.4 and just see that what is given. First you read it by yourself. Mean of, if the mean of 2x and y, mean of 2x, y, it is given like this way. Mean of 2x and y. Is 8. Mean of this three number is given 8, and you are looking for find the mean of, it is written find the mean of x. I am just writing the basic of that, mean of x, y and 8. This is what you have to find, this is what you are given. Okay, some tricky looking example, but they are actually not, dear student. You are given the mean of 2x and y, that is 8. So what first you do? First, dear student, you directly write the formula of mean. What is that? X bar equal to sigma x upon n, you know. Please concentrate. Mean is given 8. Sigma x, that means the total of this 2 plus x plus y, because there are 3 observations, 1, 2 and 3, so you will write 3 here. Cross 8, 3, this is 24 equal to 2. Please carry on with me, 2 plus x plus y. I simply applied the formula, 2 transferred on this side, 24 minus 2, that is 22, that's equal to x plus y. You got the value of x plus y. Now we are looking for median of this, mean of that. So first you will write again the basic formula, x bar, that is sigma x upon n. Sigma x, you will write this way, x plus y plus 8 upon n, that is 3. Now, dear student, you have the value of x plus y. What is that? 22, you substitute here, 22 plus 8 upon 3. 22 plus 8, 30 upon 3, that is equal to 10. Some tricky MCQ, dear student. There are lots of MCQs given to you in objective section. It's a question of you solve them, try to solve them, understand and interact your doubts with me. That is the only way we can do, understand? But some of the MCQ I would like to give you hints about, understand? Okay. Let us also solve example, one-liner number 34. You please check. One-liner number, which one we are taking? One-liner number, just take this 34. Dear student, what is said? 34, first you read that. what is said in 34th one liner, first you read, you have material with you. The mean of five observations is 40. If one observation is cancelled, the mean of the new mean is 40. What does it mean, dear student? First, what is given to you? Can you tell me? Mean is 40. At that time, you have how many observations given to you? Mean of five observations has been given to you, 40. So I have represented that data, that mean x bar equal to 40, n equal to 5. So I have mean of 5 observations as 40 already given to me. Okay, now dear student, first I am keeping a gap here. Now you read the data. Now what you need to understand and target, what is said there? If one observation is cancelled, that means, dear student, number of observations are 5. When one observation is cancelled, removed, so this becomes 5 minus 1 equal to 4. Now if you remove one observation, what is the new mean given? 40. Try to understand. Now, dear student, when number of observations were 5, x bar was 40. Now, when the number of observations are 4, x bar is 40. Here, first you apply the formula. X bar sigma x upon n, 40 equal to sigma x upon 5, you cross multiply, 45 ja, 200 equal to sigma x, this is total of 5 observation. Now here you again apply the formula, x bar equal to sigma x upon n, 40 equal to sigma x upon upon 4, as you all know, cross multiply, this will be 160 equal to sigma x. See dear student, this is total of 5 observation, this is total of 4 observation. If I subtract total of 4 observation from 5, I will get the cancelled observation. So you have to write this way. You continue this way. Okay, I have to write this way. Value of cancelled. Just write down with me. Value of cancelled observation equal to, you take total of 5 observation, then you take total of 4 observation, total of 5 observation minus 4 observation, this is going to be 40. This way such MCQ can be solved. First you verify, dear student, observation were 5, mean was 40, we applied the formula and got sigma x, which is called total of 5 observation. Then in the same way we got total of 4 observation. One observation is removed. That's why I have written minus 1. If it is asked that one observation is added, you will write 5 plus 1, 6, and then you get sigma x, and then you subtract it. You understood this? So this way, dear student, MCQs are given to you. Okay, now what we are planning, homework is about, first you just be watchful and just verify this, because MCQ can have, dear student, lots of variations in MCQ, okay? So there is no fixation like such type of MCQ one-liner will appear. You have to practice them, okay? Now this is your homework for today's lecture. Please note down the homework very consciously. Homework for today's lecture, dear student. I am giving you homework today in this way. You have to be very conscious about this. Your homework for today's lecture, which you will do, dear student, that is, this is your homework for today's lecture. means homework for this lecture number 13. I am writing it here. Homework for lecture number 13, I am writing A. So this is the first homework you have to do and submit. Understand, that is SLP 6 you have to do. Okay, but in today's lecture we have also taken the explanation of MCQ, revision of one liner also. So second homework which I am giving, I am telling it 13B. Okay, that is MCQ one liner, means total objective section. Understand, number 8 which you have to do. That suppose this homework, you are receiving this lecture on Wednesday and you will substitute this homework, dear student, for objective section. Understand, you have to submit this particular homework. Understand, on, just try to remember, this is the lecture you are receiving on Wednesday. Then how you will submit the homework, that is what I am planning and just giving you here. Okay, see dear student, objective section that you will submit, okay, objective section completely, all exercise, that is 8.1, 8.2, 8.3 and 8.4, you will submit it on the same day when there will be the next lecture, that is on Friday. So this is the homework you have to submit on Friday. Try to understand this. This is the homework submission on Friday. One homework submission for this lecture on Wednesday, another homework submission on Friday. And with this, dear student, we are completing this chapter 14 of statistics. Okay, thank you very much.